Now, last topic of the unit, complementary symmetric class B amplifier or crossover distortion and its elimination. COD, crossover distortion. Now, the question can be asked, explain complementary symmetric class B amplifier or explain what is crossover distortion and how to eliminate it. Answer to both the questions is the article which I am explaining. Complementary symmetric class B amplifier. Complementary symmetric class B, complementary means class B symmetry. Two symmetrical transistors are used. Complementary symmetry, one transistor is NPN and other transistor is PNP, right? Complementary symmetry class B amplifier, both the transistors are connected in common collector. Common collector means their output is on emitters, their output is on emitters, right? So one transistor is NPN, one transistor is PNP. A pair of NPN and PNP transistor is known as complementary pair. Both the transistors are symmetrical, hence complementary symmetry class B amplifier. I am drawing the figure. Arrow outside, this is NPN transistor. Arrow inwards, this is PNP transistor. NPN, PNP. This is collector, this is collector. Base of both are collected together and a common input is applied. Same way. Here it is plus VCC, here it is minus VCC. And since both the transistors are in common collector means their output is on emitter. Emitter this, this emitter, output is on both emitters. This is known as complementary symmetric class B amplifier. NPN, PNP. Emitter of both the transistors is connected together and on both emitters output is taken. So both the transistors, since output is on emitter, this is common collector, this is also common collector. So two common collector, one transistor NPN and one transistor PNP. So what you have to write, a complementary symmetric class B amplifier means a pair formed by using one NPN and one PNP transistor. That is complementary symmetric class B amplifier. Sine wave is applied here. So this is NPN, this is PNP. So a sine wave is applied, positive half cycle here, positive half cycle to P type base, this transistor will be followed by us, and negative half cycle here, negative half cycle to N type base, this transistor will be followed by us. So what happens? I am applying a sine wave. I will explain the working. This is the sine wave. So positive half cyclide will cycle will forward bias this transistor, negative half cycle will forward bias this transistor. So for transistor to conduct current, for transistor to turn on, emitter base voltage must be 0.7 volt. Emitter base voltage must be silicon transistor 0.7, germanium transistor 0.3. So this transistor require 0.7 volt to turn on, this transistor require 0.7 volt to turn on. So positive half cycle will provide this transistor 0.7 volt, negative half cycle will provide this transistor 0.7 volt. And since both the transistors are in common collector, their output is an emitter. So what is characteristics of common emitter, common collector? We have studied in H parameter. Common collector, voltage gain is approximately 1. Voltage gain is approximately 1. Common collector characteristics is voltage gain is approximately 1 means output is approximately equal to input. Output upon input is gain. Output upon input is gain. So if it is to be 1, output upon input is 1 means output will be equal to input approximately. So this input is going to appear across the output. But before appearing across the output, it is passing through the transistor. Out of positive cycle, this transistor will consume 0.7 volt. This transistor will consume 0.7 volt. So this is the sine wave. Suppose this is 5 volt. This is 5 volt. 0.7 of this is required to this transistor. 0.7 of this is required to this transistor. Suppose I am marking 0.7 volt. So this point to this point, this is 5 volts. So suppose this is 0.7. And this is negative half cycle 0.7. Right? So at this point, this transistor will turn on. Then, once the transistor is turned on, this input passes to output. This input is passing through the transistor. It will reach the output only when transistor is turned on. This transistor will turn on after 0.7 volt if it is silicon. And this transistor will turn on after 0.7 volt. So this transistor will take 0.7 volt from positive half cycle. This transistor will take 0.7 volt from negative half cycle. This is 0.7 volt. So after this point, this transistor will turn on and then the input will appear across the output. This positive half cycle will appear across the output after 0.7 volt. So this is 0.7 volt. It is passing. This is 0.7. Below this, it is less than 0.7. So transistor is off. So only for this period, 0.7. From here, transistor is turned on. So output will be this much only. This to this, there is no output. This to this, there is no output. Similarly for negative half cycle, this transistor. So I am marking the output. So here the transistor is turned on and here it stops. So between this period only you will get the output. Between this period only you will get the output. So I have marked this region here, positive cycle. And this much of negative half cycle. So this transistor will turn on after 0.7 volts. So this much will be the output obtained. This transistor will turn on after 0.7 volt. So this much will be the output. But between this to this, this portion, there is no output. So the portion in which transistor is not turned on, transistor is not producing any output, that portion is known as crossover distortion. The portion in which the transistor is not turned on, transistor will carry current, it will conduct only when it is turned on. So the portion in which transistor is not turned on, or the portion in which transistor is not conducting, or the portion in which we are not getting any output is known as crossover distortion. So if you are asked to explain crossover distortion, you will draw the figure. I am providing you the notes. One transistor is NPN, one transistor is PNP. NPN transistor require 0.7 volt of positive half cycle to turn on. PNP transistor require 0.7 volt of negative half cycle to turn on. And once it is turned on, remaining input, this input is passing through the transistor to output. But while passing, this transistor consumes 0.7 volt, this transistor consumes 0.7 volt, this of positive half cycle, this of negative half cycle, and remaining input appears across the output. So the portion in which the transistor is off, the portion in which transistor is not producing any output, is not conducting, that portion is known as crossover distortion. So transistor has taken 0.7 volt from sine wave, and hence the distortion is produced. So to eliminate the distortion, we have to provide it 0.7 volt from somewhere else, right? Then this input, complete positive half cycle will appear across the output, complete negative half cycle will appear across the output if we turn on both the transistors by some different method. This transistor is turned on by 0.7 volt of positive half cycle. This transistor is turned on by 0.7 volt of negative half cycle. But if we provide these 0.7 volts by some other method, then whole input will appear across the output. So to eliminate the transistor, we have to provide biasing to the transistor. So elimination is by providing voltage divider biasing to both the transistors. So to eliminate the transistors, we have to provide required 0.7 from other method, and that method is voltage divider biasing. So the transistor will be turned on by that voltage divider biasing, this transistor will be also turned on, and then whole input will appear across the output. At present, 0.7 of input is taken by this transistor, 0.7 of input is taken by this transistor. So whole input is not appearing across the output. So if we want whole input, we have to provide it 0.7 volts from other method, and that method is voltage divider biasing method. So now elimination of crossover distortion possible. Now I have provided biasing through R1, R2 and both the diodes. The diodes must be of same material as transistors. If transistors are silicon, diodes must be silicon. If transistors are germanium, diodes must be germanium. Right? So transistor and diodes must be of same material. So when I turn on the supply, current will start flowing through this. The diodes will be forward biased. Positive, negative, this will provide bias into this transistor. Positive, negative, this will provide bias into this transistor. So in previous case, 0.7 of sine wave in positive half cycle and 0.7 volt of sine wave in negative half cycle is required to turn on the transistor. But now, since I have connected resistor and diode, the transistors are forward biased due to this method. Voltage divider biasing we have studied in first chapter. So this is voltage divider biasing through R1, R2 and both the diodes. This will provide forward bias to this. This will provide forward bias to this. Both the transistors are forward biased. And now whole sine wave will pass through the transistor across the output. So in previous case, these were not there. So to turn on the transistor, 0.7 of sine wave is consumed. Now I am providing the biasing. So due to this biasing, the transistor is turned on. This transistor is turned on and whole input will appear across the output and crossover distortion will be eliminated. Right? So what is elimination of crossover distortion? We have provided voltage divider biasing through R1, R2 and both the diodes D1, D2. Once the supply is turned on, this will provide forward bias to this transistor. This will provide forward bias to this transistor. Both the transistors are forward biased. And whole positive half cycle will appear across the output through this transistor. Whole negative half cycle will appear across the output through this transistor. So the distortion which is obtained in previous case is eliminated. So to eliminate the crossover distortion, we have to provide proper biasing to the transistor. So this whole thing is explained very well in your notes. You go through the notes, note down the article and study. Right? Now we will study equation of efficiency. Now we know that efficiency is ratio of output power and input power. in transformer, in power amplifier, we know that output power is AC, input power is DC. So this is equation of efficiency number one. Output AC power Vm Im upon 2. This we have studied in previous article class amplifier. Input DC power voltage input current flowing through this supply. Since there is no resistance here, in previous case in class amplifier, here we indicated the current as Q point current, ICQ. But since there is no resistance, this current is known as direct current. The current directly flowing from the supply. So input power is voltage into current. Voltage into current. VCC into IDC. IDC or I average, in first year we have studied IDC or I average for both the transistors. For one transistor it is Im by pi, for two transistor it is 2Im by pi. This relation we have studied in first year. So I am putting IDC equal to 2Im by pi here. Now put 2 and 3 in 1. Now for maximum efficiency, Vm must be equal to VCC. So if Vm is equal to VCC, this will be cancelled. So maximum efficiency will be, this is cancelled, pi by 4 into 100%. So this is maximum efficiency of class B amplifier. Is 78.5%. Output power upon input power, IDC is 2Im by pi, that relation we have studied in first year. For maximum efficiency, Vm is equal to VC, so this is cancelled, pi by 4 into 100%. So input power is generated here, output power is given to transistor, so remaining power is delivered in both the transistors. Input generated, sum is going to output. So where is remaining power? Remaining power is divided in two transistors. So transistor dissipation. Input, out of input, sum is going to output. Input minus output is given to both the transistors. Input minus output is given to both the transistors. Input minus output. So power dissipation of each transistor. Input minus output is given to both. So to each it is divided by. Is that clear? So input power minus output power, remaining power is delivered to both the transistors, so it is divided by 2. So this is class B amplifier. So here our unit number 2 is also finished. So numericals of class A, class B, I will provide you in your WhatsApp notes. Right? So while studying, please try to note down in your notebook, in your own handwriting. And if you have any difficulty, you can ask me on WhatsApp. Okay, bye.